You know, a lot of people talk about opposite field hitting. They mentioned Tony Gwynn and how he was, oh, he hit everything to the opposite field. And I encourage you, look up his spray charts. No, he didn't. Typically, you're gonna hit the ball to the opposite field on an outside pitch. I'm gonna be able to have more time to analyze the pitch, read spin, see what pitch is coming out of the hand. Hey, it's Coach Justin from Ultimate Baseball Training. Welcome back to another video. And today we're talking a little bit about opposite field hitting and whether or not it's a good idea for you to hit everything to the opposite field. Let's get into it. All right, so first of all, let's talk about the benefits of hitting the ball to the opposite field. Why would you want to hit the ball to the opposite field in the first place? So I'm actually going to move this ball and this tee to the outer half of the plate here, because the first benefit of hitting the ball to the opposite field is you're going to let the ball travel longer, okay? Typically, you're going to hit the ball to the opposite field on an outside pitch, on an away pitch, which we'll talk a little bit more a little later on in this video, okay? So just assume that the pitch is on the outer half of the plate. Well, if it is, I'm going to let the ball travel a little bit further, and I'm actually going to hit the ball a little bit further back here like this, as opposed to a pitch over the middle of the plate or a pitch inside. So if I let the ball travel longer, think about what that's gonna do for me. It's gonna allow me to have more time to see the baseball and to react. I'm gonna be able to have more time to analyze the pitch, read spin, see what pitch is coming out of the hand, really make a good decision on whether or not I should swing at this pitch or if I should tap the brakes, right? So that's the first big advantage of hitting the ball to the opposite field, is you're gonna let the ball travel longer because you're hitting an away pitch and they have different contact points, right? You're gonna let the ball travel longer on an away pitch than you would on a pitch over the middle of the plate or a pitch inside, okay? So that's the first big advantage of hitting the ball to the opposite field. Another big advantage is staying inside the baseball. You always hear, you know, that it's a good idea to stay inside the baseball and keep your hands inside the baseball, right? Well, on an outside pitch, again, that's the one that we're going to be driving to the opposite field, your hands are basically automatically inside the baseball. It's very difficult. I'm going to over-exaggerate here, but it's very difficult for me to get my hands outside and around the baseball on an outside pitch. If it's a pitch that's, you know, inside, if it's somewhere here and I'm thinking, you know, away, 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 and all of a sudden he tries to bust me inside, then it's much easier. You see hitters kind of get around the baseball a little bit like this, and they hook the ball foul instead of keeping it fair. So on an inside pitch, I think it's a little bit easier to have that around the baseball bat path. But on an away pitch, those pitches we're taking to the opposite field, it's almost automatic. Our hands aren't going to get around the baseball. So we're going to have good hands inside the ball. We're going to stay inside the baseball. What that's going to do is that's going to promote really good bat path. You see how my bat, when I do that, is automatically on plane with the pitch super early because I'm staying inside the baseball. My bat gets on plane way back here, so I can be super late, still foul it off, or maybe even hit it down the first base line, or I can make contact right here. But keeping your hands inside the ball, staying inside the ball, that's gonna allow me to have good bat path. So that's another huge advantage of hitting the ball to the opposite field, good bat path. Then the last advantage that I think is a big advantage, there's plenty of advantages out there, but the last one that I think is a really big one, is having that good bat path is going to allow you to get more backspin and more carry. And the reason why that's so important, first of all, you know, backspin, how's that created? Well, if we hit the ball slightly below the equator, the midline of the baseball, it's gonna have backspin, right? And that's what's gonna produce that carry. If we hit the top part of the baseball above that midline, above that equator, it's gonna have top spin and it's gonna almost nosedive into the ground like this. That's not gonna go very far. So when we're talking about hitting crushing doubles and triples into the gaps and home runs, we want backspin. Well, having that good bat path, because we stayed inside the ball, having that good bat path is gonna allow us to arrive in the inside part of the baseball and slightly below the equator. That's gonna give us that good backspin and that good carry. So those are some of the advantages of hitting the ball the other way. Now there are some disadvantages to hitting the ball the other way as well. One of the big disadvantages about opposite field hitting is you're probably gonna have less power. The majority of hitters have less power to the opposite field than they do to their pull side, okay? And I want you to, this is a great angle for you to see it. On an outside pitch, the pitch that I'm taking to the opposite field, I'm not gonna be as connected here. My arms are gonna be a little bit more extended, right? We never want our arms to be completely extended at the point of contact because that just completely gets rid of all of our power. We wanna stay connected at the point of contact and get extension after contact. But the pitch is on the outer half of the plate. So if I'm standing, you know, in my normal spot in the batter's box, obviously my arms to get to that pitch are gonna be much more extended than on an inside pitch. On an inside pitch, I'm gonna hit the ball at a different contact point. It's gonna be somewhere like that. And on an inside pitch, I'm gonna keep everything nice and connected in tight to my body. So are you stronger in this position here when everything is tucked in tight to your body and connected? Or are you stronger when, I'm over-exaggerating here, but when everything is away out here like this? I'm not very strong here. I am strong in here, okay? So that's the reason why hitters have more power to their pull side as opposed to the opposite field and away pitches. So that's a big one. You're probably not gonna have as much power to the opposite field. Another big one is you might struggle with the heat. That's another disadvantage. If you're thinking about away, 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 and let the ball travel, we talked about you're gonna wait a little bit longer to hit the ball to the opposite field, let the ball travel longer. Well, what happens on a guy that throws heat? Okay, what happens with that? If you're thinking, okay, let the ball travel, you might end up struggling with, oh, I can't really catch up. So that's another disadvantage. And then going right along with that, a guy that throws heat, another disadvantage is, you know, you might get jammed on inside pitches. So if this same pitch, if I'm thinking about away, 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 and let the ball travel, and if my timing is bad or whatever, and I'm a little bit late, I'm gonna have a hard time getting to this pitch. So I might pull one of these and get jammed. I just can't get my barrel there. So that's another big disadvantage. And then the last one I think is hitters that focus on hitting everything to the opposite field. Every single pitch, regardless of the location, I think they have a tendency to kind of become a Punch and Judy style hitter. Okay, and what I mean by that is knob to the ball, that's important, keeping your hands inside the ball, all that good stuff that you hear. But I think too much of it is a bad thing. On an inside pitch, that's the pitch that you should be pulling, right? On a middle pitch, that's the pitch that you should take up the middle of the field. So if this is an inside pitch like this, and I over-exaggerate, you know, keeping my hands inside the ball and knob to the ball, I'm gonna get really, really handsy, and I'm kinda gonna be a Punch and Judy hitter because your hands are not as strong as your big muscles, your legs, your core, all that good stuff. That's where power comes from, not necessarily your hands. So I think a disadvantage is if you try to hit everything to the opposite field, you're gonna notice that, you know, a lot of hitters that try to do that are kind of more Punch and Judy style hitters with not a lot of power. So the million dollar question of should you hit everything to the opposite field, the answer is no. No, you should not hit everything to the opposite field. I think if you try to do that, you're really gonna become a one-dimensional hitter. The best hitters out there hit the ball to all fields, and they hit the ball to all fields really, really well. They hit the ball hard everywhere, okay? You gotta be able to pull it. You gotta be able to stay in the middle of the field. You've gotta be able to hit it with authority to the opposite field. So what do you do if you're not gonna hit everything to the opposite field? What's the approach? Well, when you're in a real game, when you step in the batter's box, you do your routine, right? I want you to be thinking about, and this can be applied in BP too, especially in BP, okay? Because most BP pitches are gonna be right over the middle of the plate. So what I want you to think about when you step in the batter's box, set your sights on the middle of the field. So have a middle of the field gap to gap approach. That's your starting point. You're not thinking about pulling it. You're not thinking about hitting it to the opposite field. You're thinking about, I'm staying right in the middle of the field. So BP, all right? Majority of the time, BP pitches are gonna be meatballs right over the middle of the plate. There's no reason you should be, you know, sending those down the left field line or the right field line. If it's right over the middle of the plate, that should be a pitch where you make contact a little bit out in front of your front foot and you send that right back up the box and stay in the middle of the field. And then adjust accordingly, okay? So think about initially, I'm staying in the middle of the field, gap to gap, and then the pitcher is what dictates it, okay? So if he throws me a pitch inside pitches, I'm gonna pull those pitches. Away pitches, I'm gonna hit those to the opposite field. So should you hit everything to the opposite field? No, but you are gonna be hitting pitches to the opposite field. It's just majority of the time they're gonna be away pitches, right? So I want you to think about that and always remember that each pitch location has a different contact point. So notice how I'm adjusting the tee here. On an inside pitch, I move the tee inside and up. Inside and forward more towards the pitcher because I'm gonna make contact with that pitch more out here as opposed to a middle pitch where we talked about I'm gonna make contact a little bit out in front of my front foot but not quite as far as an inside pitch. And then an away pitch, I'm gonna let that ball travel a little bit deeper and I'm gonna hit the ball a little bit more back here and send it to the opposite field. Last thing I want to say is, you know, a lot of people talk about opposite field hitting. They mentioned Tony Gwynn and how he was, oh, he hit everything to the opposite field. And I encourage you, look up his spray charts. No, he didn't. That's simply not true. He used the entire field. In fact, it was pretty equal. I mean, he hit a bunch of balls right in the middle of the field. He hit a ton of pitches to the opposite field. And then he pulled a lot of pitches and a lot of home runs, okay? So he was one of the best hitters to ever live, and he sprayed the ball all around. So if it's good enough for him, I think it's good enough for you. So to answer the question, you know, no, you shouldn't hit everything to the opposite field. It's gonna happen, but we wanna let the pitcher dictate where we're hitting the ball. We wanna make sure that we're hitting the ball at the proper contact point, and the rest will take care of itself. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button. I'd really appreciate that. It's just one click away and it would really help me out. So please smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already, because we're coming out with brand new baseball videos every single week and I don't want you to miss them. So subscribe. And last thing, hitters, I put together a free resource that I really think is going to help you out. It's called the Contact Point Checklist, and you can download it 100% for free. All you have to do is just click on the link down below in the description. I'll also leave that link in the comments section. But what I've done is I've freeze framed the swing at the point of contact, and I've highlighted a few key areas that you need to focus on. You need to make sure that you have all of these elements incorporated into your swing at the point of contact in order to really maximize your bat speed and power and your consistency at the plate. So it's 100% free. I really think it's going to help you out. Go download that right now. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.